students, welcome back to my chemistry lecture on acid, bases and salts. So today I would like to demonstrate so acids, bases, conductance and acidity by using small apparatus here. So in this arrangement I took one 9 volt battery connected to the buzzer and LED bulb here. This is the small arrangement. I have taken here different solutions. Here is the tap water, here is the petroleum, here is the sodium hydroxide solution, here is that hydrochloric acid, and this is the acetic acid. 5 different solutions I have taken here. So now let us start with the first with this petroleum. So if I take, if I keep these wires, ends of these wires in the petroleum, so what is happening? Nothing is happening. No sound, no, the bulb is not glowing. You can see now. So the bulb is not glowing, LED bulb is not glowing, and no sound coming from this beaker, from this buzzer. And if I put, but with this what you can understand, petroleum is bad conductor of electricity, it is non-electrolyte, we say petroleum spirit. Again, I'm checking this. So no bulb is, the bulb is not glowing, sound is not coming. The second one, what I'm doing here, second one, so in this I've taken the solution, sodium hydroxide solution. Now you can check, bright light is coming out, sound is coming out, more in intensity. Again, you can check it now, sound is coming and light is glowing. The second solution here I have taken is that dilute hydrogen chloride here I have taken. Now, see, check, yes, so conduction is more. And the last one is acetic acid, the feeble sound is coming, light is glowing, ding. And the sound is, see, now you can check, no sound, light is glowing, no sound. With this what we can understand, acetic acid is weak electrolyte, acetic acid is a weak electrolyte. And I have taken in this tap water, I have taken, check now, light is glowing but no sound. Is it weak acid? Actually water should be bad conductor of electricity, but the light is coming out. Can you guess the reason? What could be the reason? Because the tap water, I didn't take the distilled water, I have taken the tap water. Tap water containing minerals, ions, which conduct electricity. See, tap water is conducting electricity. Tap water is conducting electricity because of presence of ions, we say. So here, acetic acid is the weak electrolyte. Hydrochloric acid is a strong electrolyte. Sodium hydroxide is a strong electrolyte. Petroleum is a bad electrolyte. So from this experiment, what we can conclude? Acetic acid, strength of ionization. In this solution, number of hydronium ions, acetic ions, less than 20%, let us say. So weak ionization strength is very less. H plus ions number is less in this. If you take this hydrochloric acid, strong acid, number of ions more than 30%, complete ionization, H plus ions are more in this. So the pH value is less, strength, strong electrolyte it is. And if you look at this sodium hydroxide, it is a strong alkali solution, strength of ionization is more. Alkali means highly soluble in water, produces more hydroxyl ion. And in this petroleum, no ions, no ionization, number of ions will be so zero, completely molecules in this, so covalent molecules, no ionization. Tap water, actually distilled water is bad electrolyte, bad conductor of electricity, but this is a tap water containing ions and minerals, so it is poor electrolyte or weak electrolyte because of presence of ions, we say. If you take pure distilled water is bad conductor of electricity, but I have taken tap water containing ions. So with this, what we can prove means, acids have the common ion is hydronium, and whereas the base have the common ion is OH minus ion. So from this small activity, we can prove that acids and bases conduct electricity, or they are strong electrolytes, and from acids and bases also you can produce electricity by making electrochemical cells. By making electrochemical cells, we can generate electricity from the acids. Okay, so this is small activity. So thank you. So this is a fun feeling.